paddleboard racing is an endurance sport, and so there's two things to it. There's endurance, fitness, and there's technique. And the endurance fitness is what I haven't been doing all winter, so that's sort of lacking. But you can get the endurance fitness by cycling, by rowing. There are lots of things that will build your cardio, but there's no way to simulate the technique of paddling other than to get out there and paddle. And I guess two things. The two tips that I remember out of all the tips that I've heard from people describing good paddle technique, good racing technique. One is put your paddle in the water before you pull. Lots of people, they reach forward, paddles here, they start pulling. Now I'll do it over here too. They reach forward, here, they start pulling. Now, once your whole paddle head is, until your whole paddle head's in the water, you're just wasting range. And so set the whole paddle in the water first, and then pull. And then the other piece of it is, don't visualize pulling the paddle toward you. Visualize, you know, water is really hard. Once you stick it there, it doesn't move much. When you're a really good paddler, that paddle moves back only an inch or two when you're paddling. So think of it as like it's stationary. And what you're doing is you're pulling yourself past it. And so that helps you visualize it's not just about your arms pulling the paddle back. That's really about using your arms as like the anchor to pull your feet and body forward, because the only part of you that's connected to the board is your feet. And so actually what you're trying to do is you're trying to pull your feet forward using your hands as the place to pull from. And I forget that every time I go out there, but if you think about it after you're done, sometimes you can help think about what the paddle stroke should be like.